let's talk about a vulnerability class that maybe requires less technical knowledge than most other attacks, so it can be a great area for people who just started doing bug bounty, but a good understanding of an app's functionality is required. So Google asked me to talk with you about authorization bugs and lateral escalation vulnerabilities. These terms may sound very technical and crazy, but let me explain. Let's start by talking about the difference between authentication and authorization. Authentication describes functionality that identifies a user. For example, your username and password can authenticate, so identify you, so Google can give you access to your Google Mail. Authorization, on the other hand, is about what a user is allowed to do. For example, in Google Drive, authorization checks decide if you are allowed to access a certain document or if you are only allowed to leave comments or even edit the document. Those are questions of authorization. So authorization is usually more important in bigger web applications. Simple web apps oftentimes have no difference in user roles, or maybe only two. So oftentimes you could have an admin user, which can access restricted admin APIs, and you have regular users that should not be able to access the admin API. So an example authorization bug is it when it turns out a regular user can access an admin API endpoint. In contrast, an authentication bug would be if you manage to log in as an admin by exploiting an SQL injection in the login field, for example. So authorization bugs are about the permissions certain users have, and in big complex applications, especially those used by a big company, you might have very complex permission systems, and that's why we talk about it now. Let's have a quick look at Google Cloud, how a complex authorization system can look like. On Google Cloud, you can run tons of different services like databases, Kubernetes, storage systems, whatever you want. And here in the identity and access management, you can see the different user and service accounts, including their roles and permissions. And in very big companies with multiple engineering teams, you might want to carefully control what kind of access each employee has. You see, it can get complex fast. So let's talk about the challenge with permissions and roles and how this relates to bug bounty. Let's imagine a web app with a functionality to impersonate other users. But this can only be done if you have the impersonate user permission. This is intended for a developer or support staff to debug weird account issues. But giving direct access to any account is a huge invasive act. So this permission is only given to team leads. Regular support staff or regular developers cannot do that. But each support staff has the permission to change the email of an account because users might have account issues and request email changes. On first sight, this seems reasonable, but actually this email change permission can be abused in lateral escalation. Here's how. A support staff can change the email of a user to their own email, then use the forget password functionality of the app to change the password and then log in. They got access to the account even though they didn't have the impersonate user permission. I guess that's not surprising, but that's the crux of the matter. When you try to come up with reasonable permissions and design what users are allowed to do, indirectly, users might have very critical permissions, even though it doesn't seem so at first. And now when we talk about bug bounty, a lot of apps have certain default permissions for users or have permissions that seem harmless but are actually very powerful. And in those cases, it might be worth reporting it to Google's bug bounty program. However, keep in mind that fixes for these issues can be very complex and might require a lot of Google internal discussion from many different teams. It's often not easy to evaluate if it's intended or if it has privacy, abuse, security, or other kinds of impacts. So you really have to make a good case why you think a certain permission is not good and how it can be abused. You really need to be sure of it. And then give Google some time to figure out what they think they should do. But this is not all when it comes to authorization bugs. We just talked about individual permissions, but in big applications like Google Cloud, you also have roles. and roles combine multiple permissions. For example, the owner role or editor role. They are massive roles and give you over 4,000 individual permissions. While more fine-grained roles, like Cloud Run Admin, gives you 20 permissions. Google Cloud also has some cool features here because you can analyze those roles. When doing that, they try to see which actual permissions this user requires, and Google Cloud thinks that some of them are access permissions. It seems like this particular user with the admin role is not requiring all of those permissions. So you could remove individual ones that are not actually needed for this particular example organization. Anyway, when doing bug bounty, we need to think and understand what the purpose of a certain role is and if it matches expectations. A good start for that is the documentation about the roles, and the article on the Google Bug Hunter site has a good example of this. If the documentation says, users must have the owner role on the file to change the file name, and you find out that a user with the editor role is also able to change the file name, we consider this to be a vulnerability because the word must implies an obligation. In this case, it's not clear that you could have used a less privileged editor role. But if the documentation says the owner of the file can change the file name, then we might just fix the documentation to clarify that an editor is also able to change the file name because the word can implies a possibility but not an obligation. As you can see, for auditing permissions and roles, no real technical knowledge is required, but you still need a lot of in-depth understanding of the app's functionality. It's definitely more difficult than copy and pasting XSS payloads, but also no technical skill required. Before we end this video, there's one last confusing area of authorization bugs worth talking about, especially in Google's case, because Google offers tons and tons of API endpoints, and certain apps might only use some of the endpoints exposed to the UI. But when you poke around the APIs, you can find undocumented endpoints that still work. And it's important to understand that that is not necessarily a security issue. Just because no button for it is on the page, it doesn't give the user special access. So think about the first example for authorization bugs in this video. Maybe the undocumented API is an admin API that you shouldn't access. In that case, it's a bug. But oftentimes it's just a harmless endpoint that doesn't give special privileges and is just not used by the UI. In that case, it's not a bug. And then there's one more thing that is really confusing. Sometimes there are endpoints that seem to be only accessible to admins, for example, list all files. For an admin, this would literally return all files of all users. And you notice that when you as a regular user access this API, you actually return some data as well. You might think you found a bug, but the response is already filtered, matching your user's permission. You only return files that you own. So you use the admin endpoint, but the results are perfectly in line with what your user can access. In such a case, it's not a security issue either. So to summarize, hunting for authorization bugs doesn't require a lot of technical knowledge, but it requires a very good understanding of the app's functionality and use case. You really need to show impact and make a good case why you believe a certain permission or role is bad. This can be done, for example, by showing a mismatch between the documentation and what is actually implemented. However, a mismatch between what the UI exposes to the user and what the actual API offers is often not a bug. In the end, it's always important to prove impact and make very clear arguments why something has practical security-related consequences. And let me give you some personal advice. Even though it requires you to spend a lot of time to learn about the application's functionality, to understand if there are authorization bugs, it's not a waste of your time because when you select a target to hunt on and you start playing around with the different roles and permissions, you will learn a lot about all the features of the app. And when you then slowly move into the more technical attacks, you might have already noticed weird behaviors and identified areas that are worth looking into. So it will be much easier to come up with interesting attack ideas. So, good luck hunting.